What is intermittent explosive disorder and what do we do about it? That's what I'm talking about today. I'm Dr. Tracey Marks, a psychiatrist, and I make mental health education videos. This video is based on several viewer questions, and some of the questions were around distinguishing it from bipolar disorder. Other people asked me about it because they were diagnosed with it and they wanted to understand it better. So before I define it, let's look at an example of what this can look like. And this is adapted from the DSM-5 casebook. Joe is a business executive. His wife, Sally, insisted that he see a psychiatrist for help with his anger. His wife told the psychiatrist he was impossible to live with. Sally said Joe was always high-strung, but over the years, his outbursts were getting more frequent and intense, so she feared he would start getting violent with her or the kids. Their most recent argument began when Joe came home after a hard day at work to find that dinner wasn't ready. Instead, he found Sally soaking in the tub reading the newspaper. He exploded and launched into a tirade about how bad of a wife she was. When she tried to explain how she had a long day and needed to de-stress, Joe cursed at her, threw his shoe, and broke a chair. Terrified, Sally scooped up the kids and left. She put on her clothes, though. She then told Joe he would have to get some help or she would leave him. Joe said his blow-ups began in childhood, but really didn't become a problem until he was around 13. And then he had frequent fights with classmates and had to go to the principal's office a lot. Currently, Joe was having 4 verbal outbursts a week, and about every other month he would break something. The last time he threw a computer and punched several holes in the wall. He said that he never hit anyone, and these blow-ups only lasted a few minutes and then he'd feel better. As for alcohol, Joe drank occasionally, but not really on a regular basis. He was never drunk or tipsy when he got angry. In fact, alcohol tended to make him more mellow and actually make him explode less. So that's one way that this can look. Let's look at how we diagnose intermittent explosive disorder using the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders, the 5th edition. You have recurrent behavioral outbursts that are a failure to control your aggressive impulses as manifested by either of the following 2 scenarios. 1, you have high frequency, low intensity outbursts, and the low intensity would be defined as verbal aggression like temper tantrums, tirades, verbal arguments or fights, or physical aggression toward property, animals, or other people, but the physical aggression does not result in property damage or injury to someone. So in this case, the physical aggression could be pushing or grabbing your clothes. As for frequency, they occur on an average of 2x a week for at least 3 months. The second scenario is that you would have low frequency, high intensity outbursts. And in this case, the high intensity would involve damage or destruction of property, physical assault that does involve physical injury against the person. And as for intensity, it would occur around 3 times in a 12-month period, so much less often. Other criteria is that the magnitude of the aggression is grossly out of proportion to the provocation or any other triggers. You have to be at least age 6, so this can be diagnosed in children. In fact, it often is. The outbursts are not premeditated or intentional. Lastly, the aggressive outbursts either cause a lot of distress for the person or a lot of problems with your life, with your work, the way you relate to people. You may have financial or legal consequences. So this is not having an anger outburst that lasts you, that ends up landing you in a couple of arguments a few times a year, or putting your fist through a wall 2x when you're drunk. These are outbursts that are way over the top because the action doesn't match the situation and it causes serious problems for you. A few commenters questioned if their anger could really be bipolar disorder, and there's so much more to bipolar disorder than impulsivity and anger. In fact, not everyone who becomes manic and impulsive is angry. I did a video breaking down the details of mania and hypomania so you can better understand the complexities of the disorder. And I'll link to that video in the corner and in the description, but suffice it to say that the anger outbursts that you get with IED are more extreme, much more extreme, than what someone experiences with mania or depression. But you can have bipolar disorder and IED at the same time. When does this usually happen? It usually starts in late childhood or early adolescence. It rarely starts after age 40. Now, that doesn't mean that someone can't start having a lot of explosive anger after 40. In fact, there are medical illnesses like epilepsy and other brain disorders like stroke that can cause personality changes that may lead to this kind of behavior. But in that case, it wouldn't be called intermittent explosive disorder. It would be a behavioral disturbance due to whatever the medical condition is. This disorder does run in families, so if you have a first degree relative, like a parent or a sibling with it, you are at a greater risk of having it. What causes it? We don't know exactly, but people with IED do have abnormal functioning of the brain chemical serotonin, and they have a hyperreactive amygdala. The amygdala is a structure in your brain that helps detect fear and threat level. What do we do about it? The two approaches are therapy and medication. The therapy would focus on building skills and improving coping mechanisms. You'd also identify triggers as best you can, and then learn different techniques to process your aggression in a less destructive way. Medications can be serotonin-enhancing antidepressants like Prozac or even mood stabilizers, and some people have responded well to beta blockers like propranolol, which is a blood pressure medication that we use in psychiatry for anxiety and impulse control problems. If you're interested in anger in general and the source of it, watch this video that's showing up right here. For more information on mental health education, subscribe to my channel. I publish videos every Wednesday at 9. See you next time.